Nafisa, the first leads are now beginning to come in, and your expectations from Lucknow this morning.
Yes, good morning to India. Morning. Times now will tell us the story.
Well, we are waiting. We haven't got any leads from Lucknow yet, unfortunately. But you had a stiff three-corner contest to be fighting there, and you had the outsider tag put against you. Will you, in the event of not making it today, wrap up your political career at this point? And if you won't, then what's the next step you will take? I don't want to sound fatalistic, but what are the options you're considering?
No, Arnab, the important thing is that we must realize that UP is in severe trouble regarding the right way of governance. And we need to work to ensure that the BSP and their, I would say, arrogance and almost dictatorship-oriented policies are addressed. And that's why Samajwadi Party really is the only party presently who can take that on. And the sad part is, now that I'm watching the analysis of what are the likely results of UP, if the BJP grows, it's only because the Congress and the Samajwadi Party didn't ally together or fight friendly fights on certain seats. Imagine if Congress had taken the 7 seats that the SP were suggesting, and we together fought on maybe another 5-6 seats. Then the Samajwadi Party and the Congress would be a force to reckon with here in UP, instead of diluting all our vote bank. And this needs to be thought about very seriously, because after all, UP is 80 seats, and to allow a communal, a polarized kind of a party to come forward, which is the BJP, I think India deserves better. So I'm hoping that we learn from all this, and whether I win or lose is immaterial. Important thing is, as an activist, as a social worker, as a committed person, I have resolved not only that Samajwadi Party should form the next government in UP, but also it should become a national party.
All the very best. We'll know. We'll talk to you in 2 hours when the results are out.